nabantu abangafuni oh uyazenzela wena munye yenzele babona ukuthi haya exist kodwa lapha ngikulayo yakho never usarambe kubantu abangaboni ukuthi uyabukusarana yourself nabantu abagreater the best in you ekugcineni it's all about your life yakho you need to represent your name ekunoma kungabanzima ilife ikushaye la ushaye ungakhumbula igama lakho there's a reason why igama lakho bakunikile khumbula igama lakho Remember, do not forget your background. It prevented putting up. You need to leave a mark. You need to leave your name in the history. You would now tell a young generation back to move. Why you call it a new to be in the It prevented it is your choice. Thank you.
In the local community?
These initiatives and programs, they are very important because they bring together people and they also create that environment for people to bring back to this many other members. That's what I am, it's all about. So we have to also create the culture also to bring it all together. And you can also create projects like this to take the kids away from the streets and also to be informed about certain things.
So powerful. This is a school that you used to go to. What does it feel like looking at the school and not seeing that it's progressed after you've been here?
It feels very sad, because knowing how many school kids went out of this school, how many of them are very good in what they're doing now, they have a bright future. So it's very sad to see the school going downwards. So the reason for me to be here is also trying our best so that the next generation also get this school in a good state and in a good standard.
So it's a Saturday afternoon. Why did you decide to come and do this initiative here?
I came here this morning to help out the community of the school and help other initiatives that I like to run.
So tell us a little bit more about the organization and some of its initiatives.
It's an annual organization dealing with children with health, social development. We also, basically we're dealing with things. We make sure that we group together the children from the streets, we combine them, we do them the activities, we teach them education, we teach everything that's going to make their life better in the future.
I think, as I always tell people must not wait for government. They must just do anything and everything from their own pockets. For instance, like us, the Ground Rovers. This is not our first event. cleaner scaler. We also did the pet drive because we know that there are people who are struggling. Actually, most of our youth, they're struggling a lot about with pets and all that. So we took the initiative to do the pet drive so that we can, like, via school to school to deliver pets for them. And also the community ones. We do have the community events that we deliver our pets individually in their house. So they can also do that, not wait for government. They can do something. It's not only a pet drive or what, but there are a lot of things you can do in order just to have that thing.
In regards to the school administration and the school maintenance, what is currently some of the challenges that this school has in regards to the structure and its facilities?
For me, the previous principal, I would say, was not good because the administration is non-existent, the maintenance is non-existent, because the slightest things like taps, they're not working, a toilet, something whereby you give your kids for something like 6 hours a day, the room is not working. So simply tells you how far the maintenance is very bad. So you cannot even mention the administration, because as a principal, you have to look at certain key people for certain areas and put them in place.
Where do you see Soweto in the next 5 years?
Soweto is old.
Is it to create activities for children so that they don't end up in negative situations in life?
Creating activities for children is how we give back to the society. It's how we let kids are aware of what it is that is around them and how they can in turn give back to the community.
Don't want to ask anyone, don't want to pay it anymore, don't want property anymore. The reason why we do this, why everything to be together, why we fight better and achieve everything. Our economy, or our community economy must be better after 5 years from now.
It's just this sort of thing, like scented, looking nice, producing kids that are good, less with the drug activity, more sports activity, more cultural activities. So, which means the next 5 years can be a great 5 years.
Power. So, what's your motivation or message of motivation to community members, to parents from Kwapala Primary?
For me, what I can say to motivate other people, I mean, we're all from different backgrounds. It doesn't mean if you're from a bad background, you must allow other people to get bad backgrounds as well. You can do something positive with it. You can plow in, whether you have one less, you can put it in, or whether you feel you have skills of painting, come paint the school. You will teach somebody how to paint the school. Then that thing that you taught somebody will also grow. It will be nice, wonderful chain. Some others will take that, it will be a business for them. They will have food in their tables because of what you did.
Power. Now, if there are organizations out there that can contribute with resources, what resources do the ground movers need right now?
If there are certain companies or certain foundations that can assist us, we'd be very happy. For one, as in a school here, we would need a lot of tiles, gutters, you name it, things to fix this. Like a contract company would be very nice for us. It will help a lot. We will also help that certain company to market it also, because they're doing something for us. So we also have to do something for them also. And I think it would be very nice if you can get companies to us.
I would want Soweto to be obviously a better place to be. Anyone, wherever, where they come from, would say, I want to go to Soweto. Because in Soweto, I think for one, I would go back to that entertainment thing that I'm doing. We used to do the African dance and all that. I mean, overseas, when you go into Inland, they want to come to South Africa open Inland. So now I think they would do something very unique, with people from overseas or from wherever abroad can come as well just to see that. So that's the only thing I would change. With nothing better than us from wherever they come from, but to see us do something different.
So what can Sowetans begin to understand about supporting these type of initiatives?
Okay, the Sowetans can understand if you do come and support this kind of initiatives, you get to meet people, you get to network with other people, and you get to have other perspectives and other knowledges that you didn't have. Like when you're sitting in the corner, the person that you'll be talking to is the one that is watching the same TV show that you're watching. So they might bring something new on the table. So when you come to places like this, you meet people from other places with another mindset. So it's going to teach you something new, and if you come here to help out, you'll be gaining some skills.
For me, what I can say to motivate other people, I mean, we're all from different backgrounds. It doesn't mean if you're from a bad background, you must allow other people to get bad backgrounds as well. You can do something